Hello again, this is Marxist, and this is episode 2 of my Learning from the Classics series. If you haven't seen episode 1, there's an annotation below that you can click on. Otherwise, without further ado, we'll get into our first situation in this. It's the first real mid-fight of the game, and we're going to watch it from the overhead view, just to see what we can get a sense of as far as mid-strats go. The actual first mid of the game, Quantic Medic CB crashed, and so Quantic couldn't really go to mid. As it stands right now, Quantic's leading 1-0. On this first mid, both demos go house. Quantic's gonna split their team up with two people going right and the rest going left. The entirety of mix-up goes right besides Platt, and even Platt sort of joins in the fray. And Quantic ends up getting cut in half, basically, and they're all dead. So what happened? Mixup moved in a very strong way to their right side, and Quantic split their forces, with essentially two people heading up to their train car, two going right, and one person, Banny, staying in the house. What happens is when Mixup takes their very strong five-person engagement on the right, they only find 2 to 3 players over there, and they're easily just pushed aside and killed before the rest of Quantic can show up and help. As a result, Mixup wins the mid easily, and it shows the importance of moving as a singular unit on mid. Even if you don't normally use the blob strat, it's very important for that to be done on mid. Quantic tries to go for a strategy where Mackie's going to do early damage and a scout will follow up, and hopefully delaying the team that would have gone train car. Since there's no team at train car at all, they don't do anything and their whole team's dead before they have the opportunity to respond. It also shows the benefit that you can derive from reactive style mids, because somebody ought to have been able to see that basically all of Mixup was headed to the right in Valley, and thus nobody really needed to be jumping to Quantic's right. The next situation we're going to look at is a fast push after a mid wipe executed by Mixup, which comes right after the mid we just watched. It's a play akin to a fast break in basketball that a lot of newer teams that I've mentored don't seem to be aware of as an option for them to use. And what you do here is if you've wiped the enemy team at mid and your pocket med and demo all survive, it's well within your capability to push to last immediately and have it work. We're gonna watch this happen from Platinum's perspective. He's gonna follow in the combo here, and they're gonna go to upper lobby. It doesn't really matter which door you would use here. TLR is gonna go on a soldier, and Platt's gonna look at sticking out a spawn door, but there's nobody really there. They get a quick pick on Mackie, who tried to go sniper, and there's a pyro in the way, which is kind of screwing over TLR. Platt's gonna deal with that. Harb baits the point. Platt knocks the sticks off, which is very important. And then now the point is baited, and most of Quantic's dead anyhow. You can see here the strength of bringing an Uber to last before a team is set up or expecting you to be there. Platt looks at sticking out spawn doors, which is a perfectly viable option since there were people in spawn. They just came out of the right side. Harb goes to the point quickly, and Platt knocks the stickies off. The pyro gets juggled around and can't really do a whole lot after he throws TLR away, because two sets of projectiles coming at him is, even for a pro holder downer of Mouse 2, it's just too much. Then the rest of Mixup comes in and deals with Quantic, which is having to stop the point, so they've dropped down to some degree and are getting beat up on by the Mixup players that are now coming in off of the spire. This is a great way to punish teams that have a habit of wiping at mid, with you retaining a lot of your team through the mid fight. It's also something to work on, because the first couple times you'll try to do it, it might not work. And it's sometimes easy for that Uber to get botched, but it's much easier than assembling in lobby, waiting for them to get their heavy pyro, sniper, NG defense set up, and then trying to push into that. Here we're going to watch the third mid-fight of the game, and the second real mid-fight that occurred in this match, also from an overhead view. What's going to happen at this minute is that both teams opt for a traditional left-side house type rollout, and they're both going to play off of their own train cars. Quanta gets in the early bomb, but Harblu gets knocked to the ground. And then his team ends up getting sort of cut in half with his scouts on the right and the rest of his team standing on the train car. And they get picked apart, and Quantic ends up taking this mid. However, something very important happens as TLR and both scouts are still alive. TLR bombs in, everybody's distracted by TLR, and both scouts come in from two different doors and pick the medic, saving the round. What happened here is that Mixup, despite getting the early frags, ends up getting picked apart. And what happened to them there is Harb gets knocked to the ground, he can't heal anybody, and Relic and a scout get a little overextended into them, or at least they went in to do damage and TLR and Platinum were unable to follow up, either because they didn't have ammo loaded, or they just weren't ready to, and as such they end up dying for nothing. But the important part of the end of that mid is that because Harb died, Mixup knows they have to kill CB, Quantic's medic, or they're going to lose the round, because Quantic has enough players that they will get a very speedy last push going. Not quite as speedy as the last one, because there are several players dead for Quantic, but they'll still be facing an Uber versus no Uber situation at last, and there's not a lot they can do about that. However, with a well-orchestrated play that was made on the fly, they're able to kill CB and save the round. They use one player as bait, and then the other two come in through two different doors, essentially flanking the medic from two different angles, and they're both fixed on him. What TLR does there is he goes in first, he has the most health, he makes the most noise, and he's the scariest, really, of all the three. So everybody looks at him. He reports to the scouts where the medic is, and the scouts go and kill him. In situation 4, we'll be watching a traditional pocket-style Uber with slight Uber advantage from Mixup onto Quantic, who's holding mid. CB is very close to Uber, but he doesn't quite have it yet. TLR is getting ready to take the Uber. He goes through, and Harb pops really early, and everything is too far away for TLR to get to. Normally on an advantage push, popping really early is okay, but they weren't really threatened in this case. As such, CB's Uber is going to come back in on them, and there's not really much TLR or anything Mixup can do about it. They get a few frags here and there, but it's not enough really to solve the problem. Then all the remaining players on Mixup's sole goal is to kill CB to take away the Uber advantage he just got. My general rule of thumb is that if you're going to try to push on Uber advantage, you need to either kill their medic. In this case, that wasn't possible. CB was in his own choke, far too far away for TLR to get to. Or you need to get two frags, and the way you accomplish that is by bringing in a lot of people on your Uber. Because if it's a 4v6, you can usually kite it and then win the fight that comes after. Mixup wasn't able to do either of those things, and their Uber was popped very, very early. Maybe TLR saw a trap that I didn't see, or something strange went on that would justify that. Normally in an advantage push, it's okay to pop really early, but in this case, it turned Mixup's Uber into a disaster, because they were unable to get at anyone or kill anyone until the Uber had already come in on them and destroyed Mixup's ability to cap. Then the fight becomes a futile attempt to kill the medic. If your team is in Quantic's position, you should do what Quantic did. CB was completely surrounded in a circle of all surviving team members, and it made it really difficult for the surviving players on Mixup to get at him and get that kill that they needed. In our fifth situation, we'll watch Mixup push into Spire, Uber versus Uber. They'll utilize the Roamer Bomb to get the Uber out of Quantic so that they will have their own Uber advantage to push into Spire with. Here we see Relic go for the bomb. He goes straight for CB, and he makes him pop. Then he jumps to Spire to try and pull the team back towards him, and he dies. But his mission is complete. Then Mixup's Uber comes back out, and TLR comes in and gets several frags, and then heads straight up to Spire to begin capping it. The rest of his team joins, and Quantic's sort of stuck behind. They're not going to stop Spire. What happened here is that Relic's bomb was a success. TLR was able to get a much better Uber, and Quantic was thrown into disarray with their flank becoming trapped behind. As such, they're going to die very late and will not be able to defend last. In our sixth situation, we'll be watching a mid, the fourth mid of the game, from Platinum's perspective. After the Uber in the previous video, Mixup goes on to easily win the round. So we're going to see part of Plat's rollout here. I didn't catch the whole thing because that's not what this video is about. And he's going to go window. He sees that Banny's on mid. So his option here is basically just to stick mid and hope he gets some good pipes. And he's going to drop down. He already loses a player. And the second player going down, third player going down, he knows he's lost. So he's just going to try and see if he can finish anything. And he can't, so he escapes. I show this because it shows some of the limitations of going window as part of the rollout for demo in certain situations. And that's when the demo presses up very aggressively on the middle point. Platt's team isn't able to accomplish a whole lot. And the other reason that I show it is because it shows Platinum backing out on a logical scale. Generally, if you give up two picks at the start of mid, you've lost. And I think really the only thing that kept him in there was probably that somebody was calling that they were very hurt. So he tries to get one more sticky off before he bails out. And getting out is a very important thing. In fact, I think a lot of the struggle of newer teams is that they constantly wipe at mid. And this shows you a baseline of how one of the best players in the game decides to get out, given his whole team is dead besides him. But he starts playing a bit more passively as soon as two players go down right at the start, and begins backing out after the third goes down. And to keep this video nice and short, we're going to cut it off here. You should have a clickable link to part 3 once it's out. And I hope you found this to be enjoyable and informative. So until next time.